When you add an app or link to your district's Clever portal, you'll see a few different configurations based on its type. Now, we'll talk about each resource type so you can make quick work of adding resources to your district's Clever portal, regardless of type. We'll also discuss how you can get connected with an app in Clever. First, let's talk about the different types of apps or programs you can connect with in Clever. The five app types are rostering, single sign-on or SSO, rostering and SSO, SSO saved passwords, and library apps. By the way, a sixth resource I wanted to call out are links. You can also add links to literally anything in your district's Clever portal. More on that in a moment. Now, let's talk about each app type. As you might remember, rostering maintains up-to-date roster information in your learning applications. For apps with rostering, Clever will securely transfer your district's data. Then, applications automatically create and organize accounts for your users, even students and teachers. Meanwhile, applications with single sign-on, or SSO for short, let you log in to your account instantly by clicking the apps icon in your Clever portal. Here's some great news. Many apps in Clever support rostering and SSO. This means all rostering and SSO data is synced to the application when it's being used in Clever. Next up are SSO saved passwords applications. These apps don't currently have rostering or SSO integrations with Clever, but they can still be accessed via SSO through Clever Portal with our saved passwords feature. This means districts can provide users with a seamless SSO experience for almost any learning application, even if it's not one of our hundreds of existing Clever partners. With SSO saved passwords apps, Clever does not sync rostering data and user accounts to the app. This means they must be created within the application in advance, and user login credentials need to be manually set by the district admin or the users themselves. Clever will securely store these credentials so district users are logged into the applications automatically via SSO through Clever. If you're trying to add an app on Clever and don't see any integration with Clever, simply click the Request button and provide some basic information. Our team will assist with creating a saved passwords application. No more trying to remember various usernames and passwords. Use Clever to log into any application. Clever Library is a place for teachers to discover, learn about, and adopt new resources for their classrooms. All Clever Library apps offer a free version and include rostering and SSO for teacher accounts. Teachers can add library apps to their teacher pages for easy access by students. Finally, we have links. Links aren't programs with rostering or SSO into Clever. They're just plain old links. I wanted to make sure you remembered that you can add any link to your district Clever portal. Example links you might add include your district's website, the district tech support form, a link to a PDF with your school year schedule, or your learning management system. By adding links in addition to your district's apps, you can make Clever Portal the one-stop shop for district resources. Now that you're acquainted with app types and links, let's talk about how to add apps to your Clever Portal. There are two ways to get connected with an app: requesting it or being invited to connect by its team. You can request the app in your Clever account by following these steps. This notifies the app, such as IXL, that you'd like to connect with it. When an app invites you to connect with it, you'll receive an email and see this notification in your Clever account. For either option, you'll have full control over what data to send to the app. For more information on sharing data with apps, please check out our Help Center or Clever Academy. I know we just covered a fair bit of ground. Rest assured, you can always come back to this video if you need a rundown of different types of Clever apps and how to get connected.